Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 11th of February. India-China agreed to disengage troops along Pangong Lake area in Ladakh. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani seeks allies as talk of interim government mounts. And Sri Lanka to allow COVID burials for Muslims after global outcry. And now for all the details. India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh informed the Parliament on Thursday that India and China have agreed to pull back troops from the Pangong Lake area in the Himalayan region of Ladakh. Singh said the accord had been reached after several rounds of talks to diffuse tensions amid months-long border standoff.
India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh told the Parliament on Thursday that India and China have agreed to pull back troops from the bitterly contested Pangong Lake area, high in the Himalayan region of Ladakh, in a breakthrough after a months-long standoff on the disputed border. Rajnath Singh said the accord had been reached after several rounds of talks between military commanders and diplomats from the nuclear-armed neighbors. Once the disengagement has been completed at the high-altitude Pangong Lake, military commanders will meet within 48 hours to discuss pullback from other areas, Rajnath Singh said, while adding that India is committed to maintaining bilateral ties.
Pati Mahoday, mujhe sadan ko yeh batate hue khushi ho rahi hai ki hamare is approach tatha sustained talks ke phalswarup Chin ke saath Pangong Lake ke north yam south bank par disengagement ka samjhota ho gaya hai.
India-China border tensions had escalated after 20 Indian soldiers were killed in a violent standoff with the Chinese troops in Ladakh's Galwan Valley in June last year. Later on Thursday, a video released by the Indian Army showed high-ranking military officials of India and China shaking hands and troops withdrawing their tanks and armoured personnel carriers from the southern bank of the Pangong Lake.
The death toll in India's Uttarakhand glacier tragedy climbed to at least 35 on Thursday. Rescuers were focused on saving over 30 construction workers stuck in the flooded tunnel who were missing since the disaster happened on Sunday. The rising water levels nearby disrupted rescue efforts for a while but resumed soon after with precautionary measures.
The death toll in glacier burst tragedy in India's northern Uttarakhand state rose to at least 35 while 204 people still remained missing, authorities said on Thursday. Rescuers were focused on saving another 35 people stuck in a flooded tunnel connected to the 520-megawatt Tapovan Vishnugar hydroelectric project who were missing since the Sunday's disaster. The rescue operations at the tunnel and other places had to be halted for a while as water levels rose in the Rishiganga River nearby but resumed soon after with precautionary measures.
जलस्तर जो है पीछे से बढ़ता हुआ आ रहा है तो उसी को सोचते हुए हमारी टीम सभी जितनी टीमें थी एनडीआरएफ थी बाकी जो भी यहां बचाव कर्मी हैं उन सभी को जो है जो सेफ स्थान है वहां पर सबको पहुंचाकर अभी यहां पर काम फिर शुरू हो गया है लेकिन जितनी भी टीमें हैं कुछ लिमिट टीमें वहां जा रही हैं जो वहां पर काम कर रही हैं.
Meanwhile, India's paramilitary Indo-Tibetan Border Force is supplying ration, food and essential items to over a dozen villages which have got disconnected from the national highway after a flash flood erupted following the glacier burst. Reports said estimated around 100 to 200 people reside in each of these villages.
India, while launching a scathing attack on Pakistan at the United Nations Security Council on Wednesday, said Pakistan has been disrupting the peace process in Afghanistan by orchestrating violent attacks through terror groups like Al-Qaeda. The intra-Afghan peace talks had resumed in January, but no progress till now has been made.
India at the United Nations Security Council on Wednesday said Pakistan has been disrupting the peace process in Afghanistan by orchestrating violent attacks through terror groups like Al-Qaeda. India's permanent representative to the United Nations, T.S. Tirumurthy, while speaking at a Security Council briefing, said the UN Secretary General's report on the militant Islamist group ISIL should also cover activities of the proscribed terrorist entities under ISIL and Al-Qaeda sanctions regime, like Lashkar-e-Taiba and other Pakistan-based groups like Jaish-e-Mohammed and frontal organizations that raise funds for their activities.
The world is fully aware that these groups also perpetrate terror activities from safe havens in Pakistan, including through violent attacks in Afghanistan that have disrupted the peace process. We are also witnessing the relocation of terror groups to Afghanistan, especially in Kunar and Nangarhar provinces across the Durand line.
The intra-Afghan peace talks between the government of Afghanistan and the Taliban had resumed in January, but no progress till now has been made. The talks were overshadowed by a series of disagreements and a surge in violence, including armed clashes and blasts across the country. However, former Pakistan Senator Afarsyab Khattak had said that Islamabad has been using the Taliban as a tool for its dominance in Afghanistan under the pretext of strategic depth.
In news from Afghanistan, as debates and discussions over the possibility of interim government persist, the Afghan government has also accelerated efforts to gain political support from mainstream politicians in the country. The Afghan government maintains that an interim government means transformation towards the dissolution of the constitution or a possible collapse in Afghanistan.
At a time when talks of an interim government are mounting in Afghanistan, President Ashraf Ghani has held a series of meetings and consultations with some Afghan influential political leaders in recent weeks. Rahmatullah Nabil, the former head of the National Directorate of Security and a critique of Ghani, has said that the president is politically isolated and is trying to gain the support of Afghanistan's major political parties and political movements. The Ghani government believes that an interim government means transformation towards the dissolution of the constitution or a possible collapse in Afghanistan. This comes as the newly elected Biden administration in the United States would review the former Trump administration's February 2020 U.S.-Taliban agreement, the White House has said. The U.S. President Joe Biden, in his first visit to the Pentagon as Commander-in-Chief, has promised to work with leaders around the world to bring a responsible end to wars that have dragged on for far too long.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan Democratic Movement Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman has said Prime Minister Imran Khan should not redirect the blame to others for the actions of his party workers. His remarks came after Khan blamed that Rahman had made vast amounts of money by selling votes during 2018 Senate polls.
After Prime Minister Imran Khan alleged that Pakistan Democratic Movement Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman made vast amounts of money while selling votes during Senate polls, Rahman responded by saying that the Premier should not redirect the blame to others for the actions of his party workers, and said that his conscience was clear. The allegations by Khan came in the backdrop of a leaked video that showed ruling PTI, Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf Party lawmakers receiving large amounts of money from Muhammad Ali Bacha, former lawmaker from the Pakistan People's Party, ahead of the Senate elections in 2018. Despite the video showing his party members accepting bribes, PM Imran Khan has said that the government was determined to stop the cycle of money laundering and corruption and supported an open ballot.
Video to unke apne logon ki hai, so jo gand unke apne haan hai, khuda ke liye apna gand apne muh par male, wo apna gand dusron ke muh pe na male.
Fazlur Rahman said the coming days are crucial for the Prime Minister as the 11-party opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement eyes a long march against the government from March 26.
Moving on, members of the rival faction of the Nepal Communist Party on Wednesday held a mass gathering in capital Kathmandu against Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's decision of dissolving the parliament in December last year. Prominent Nepali communist Pushpa Kamal Dahal, a leading opponent within the ruling party, has said the premier should resign and repent over the move. On Thursday, the rival faction of the ruling party demanded the immediate release of leader Ram Kumari Jhakri, who was arrested over her recent comments on President Bidya Devi Bhandari. Former Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal, also the chair of one faction of the NCP, Nepal Communist Party, has sought support from the international community to protect democracy in Nepal, which he said was under threat from Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli. Nepal was plunged into crisis on December 20 when Oli declared he could no longer work with rivals in his NCP, dissolved parliament and called for a fresh election more than a year ahead of schedule. While addressing a mass meeting organized by his faction in Kathmandu on Wednesday to protest against Oli's move, Dahal said the premier should resign and repent over the move.
यदि संविधान को अक्षर र भावना संविधान को मर्म र भावना विपरीत नेपाली जनता को चाहना र आकांक्षा विपरीत केही काम गरियो भने त्यो दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण हुनेछ त्यो नेपाली जनतालाई सही हुने छैन जनताको यो शान्तिपूर्ण आन्दोलन विद्रोहमा गयो भने के हुन्छ प्रत्येकले विचार गर्न जरुरी छ
ओली ब्लेम्स दहल एन्ड अदर ओपोनेंट्स इन द पार्टी फर अ ल्याक अफ कोऑपरेशन ही सीज हैज टर्माइट इफेक्टिव गभर्नमेन्ट एज द हिमालयन नेशन सिक्स टु नेभिगेट अ पेन्डेमिक इन्ड्युस्ड इकोनोमिक क्राइसिस The Supreme Court is hearing more than a dozen petitions challenging the dissolution of Parliament. Judges are expected to give their verdict this month. If the verdict is in Oli's favour, then Nepal faces an election in two phases, on April 30 and May 10. In news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka will allow the burial of COVID-19 victims, Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa said on Wednesday, following months of outcry over the ban. In response to a question raised by lawmaker S.M. Marikar, Rajapaksa said in the parliament the bodies of virus victims will be allowed to be buried. The health ministry had earlier said that the burial of coronavirus victims could lead to the virus spread. It said the bodies of the deceased, irrespective of their religion, would therefore be cremated. However, the World Health Organization stressed that cremation is a matter of cultural choice. Several non-governmental organizations and minority groups in Sri Lanka filed petitions with the Supreme Court pleading to stop the cremation of Muslim bodies. Meanwhile, Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan, who will be visiting Sri Lanka later this month, welcomed the lifting of the ban that came ahead of a UN Human Rights Council session starting as of February 15. The island nation has so far reported 72,174 coronavirus cases. Thousands of Hindu devotees gathered on Thursday in the holy cities of Haridwar, Prayagraj and other places along River Ganga in northern India to take a dip and offered prayers on the occasion of Mauni Amavasya amid coronavirus pandemic. One of the most sacred days in the Hindu calendar, Mauni Amavasya is observed with great devotion across India.
Hindu devotees in northern India on Thursday took holy dips and offered prayers on the occasion of Mauni Amavasya, No Moon Day, amid coronavirus pandemic. A large number of devotees took holy dip at the confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and mythical Saraswati rivers, along with confluences of many other rivers and ponds at several places in northern Uttar Pradesh state. Elaborate security arrangements have been put in place to control the crowd and maintain COVID-19 protocol. Mauni Amavasya is considered an auspicious day when sun and moon enter the Capricorn sign according to Hindu calendar.
सभी श्रद्धालुगण जो है बहुत श्रद्धा भक्ति से मौनी स्नान कर रहे हैं वस्तुतः यहाँ पर कोरोना काल चल रहा है और बहुत सारे डर है लेकिन फिर भी इस आस्था के सामने ये कोरोना जो बीमारी है वो फीकी पड़ गई है
Despite the pandemic and braving winter chill, thousands of devotees offered prayers and performed rituals for salvation of their ancestors in Varanasi and Haridwar. People also gave donations to priests or needy on the auspicious occasion.
नहान जो है मौन होके किया जाता है और दान दक्षिणा किया जाता है जता शक्ति जिसकी जो शक्ति होती है.
It is believed that the water of the Ganges turns into nectar on Mauni Amavasya. It is derived from the word Moni, that literally means ascetic who practices silence.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/isasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at isasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.